मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव सीन हाउ टू ड्रॉ द स्टेट डायग्राम फॉर गिवन लॉजिकल सीक्वेंशियल सर्किट, राइट। सो इन टुडेज क्लास वी विल सी हाउ टू ड्रॉ द सीक्वेंशियल सर्किट व्हेन द स्टेट डायग्राम इज गिवन। ओके, सो लेट अस डायरेक्टली स्टार्ट सॉल्विंग द प्रॉब्लम। रियलाइज द सिस्टम रिप्रेजेंटेड Realize the system represented by the following state diagram using DPF. Okay, so if such type of question occur in the examination, then you have to draw a sequential circuit when the state diagram is given by following the state diagram. Okay, so let us draw the state diagram first. The state called S1, S2, and S3. There are three states. Okay, so S1 remains in its previous in its present state when x bar and z bar, right? So wherever we have bar, we take its value as 0, right? So as we used to do in the first one, right? And whenever the variable has its true form, we will take its value as 1. Okay, so here when the present state is S1, what do you mean by this? When the present state is S1 and x is equal to 1, it will jump to the next state as S2 and output will be equal to 0. And when present state is S2 and x is equal to 0, x bar means we are taking x is equal to 0 value. And when x is equal to 0, z is equal to 0, and S2 will change its state from S2 to S1. Next, when the present state is S2, the present state is S2 and x is equal to 1, and x is equal to 1, it changes its state from S2 to S3 and z becomes equal to 0. Next, when present state is S3 and x is equal to 0, it remains in its same state and z will be equal to 0. Next, when present state is S3 and x is equal to 1, right, it changes its state from S3 to S1 and z will be equal to 1. So this is the given state diagram. So this, for this state diagram, you have to draw a logical or a sequential circuit, right? So here first we need to identify how many states are there. So total how many states here? The solution starts from identifying the number of states. How many states here in the state diagram? There are 3. Which are they? S1, S2 and S3. Now, how many bits are used to represent these states? How many bits can be used to represent these states, right? So, how many bits I should use? Right, see, let us say how many bits we require. If I use only one bit, how many states can be represented? 0 and 1, that means 2 states. If I treat 0 as one state and 1 as second state, then we can represent only 2 states. But how many states we have here in the diagram? We have total 3. So at least we require 2 bits. We require 2 bits so that with 2 bits, how many combinations we can write? We can write 4 combinations, right? With 2 bits, I can cover all 3 states, right? So for, by assuming the last state as don't care. Okay, is it clear? So out of these 4 combinations, you can treat any 3 values for to represent these states. Either 00 can be used to represent S1, 01 can be used for S2, 10 can be used for S3, 11 is left as it is. Okay, so we will understand once I start solving this problem. I hope you understood how to identify the number of states and how many bits are required to represent each state, right? So if I have one more state called S4, then all these four combinations can be used. Okay, so now with these states, with these state values, that is 0 0 0 1 1 0 and 1 1, we will try to draw the same diagram, right? So now instead of symbols S1, S2, S3 and XZ, we will replace them by zeros and ones, right? So that will help us to write our excitation table. Okay, so what I'll do here, I'll redraw this state diagram by replacing these symbols by the state values. Okay, so let us say I'll take to represent S1, I'll take 00. For S2, I'll take 01, and for S3, I'll take 10. Right? So if I replace them, and how the state diagram is going to look is in this. Okay, so 00. Wherever we have a complemented form, complemented input variable or complemented output variable, I'll replace them by 0. Right? So both are complement here, both are complemented form. So we will take a 00. Right? Next, when it changes its state, X is true form, I'll take it as 1, and Z is complemented form, I'll replace it by 0. Next, S3, X is in true form, 1, Z is complemented form, 0. Next, S3, X and Z both are complemented forms, so 0, 0. Next, X and Z both are in true form, so 1, 1. Next, from here to here, both are complemented form, so 0, 0. Right? So this is the state diagram, a modified state diagram, you can say, where symbols are replaced by their state values or input and output values. Okay. So this is the modified state diagram. So for modified state diagram, we will try to write the excitation table, right? Because what we need to draw the logic sequential circuit diagram, we need the Boolean expressions for the flip-flop inputs, right? So here we are using the D flip-flops, and we have only two values for each state. Then that means we need two flip-flops, right? So here we have used two bits to represent each state, right? So one bit is stored in one flip-flop, another bit is stored in second flip-flop, so we require two D flip-flops, right? So to draw the logic diagram, sequential circuit diagram for using D flip-flop, we need the Boolean expressions for what inputs DA and DB. Okay, so that can be obtained from the excitation table. Okay, so let us start writing the excitation table. What are the inputs? A and B are the state values, present states, and X is the input. Similarly, we will have the next states as A plus and B plus, right? And we will be having the flip-flop inputs DA and DB. Next, we have the output, which is Z, right? So these columns we need to fill out, and we need to obtain the Boolean expressions for DA and DB to fill out to draw the final circuit diagram. Okay, so now there are three inputs, the present states and the present input, right? So there are three total, so we can write total eight combinations: 0 0 0 0 0 1 0 1 0 0 1 1 1 0 0 1 0 1 1 1 0 1 1 1. Right? So now just you have to write the next state by referring the state diagram and the value X. Right? See here how to write the first next state. Right? So when the present state is 0, 0, where is 0, 0 here, right? And X is equal to 0, where X is equal to 0 here, follow the arrow mark. Either it jumps to the same state either it remains in its same state or it will jump to the next state, right? So depending on the value of x. What is the value of x here? This is the value of x, this is the value of output, that is z. When x is equal to 0 and present state is 0, it remains in its previous state, this arrow mark, right? So it remains in its previous state, that is 0, 0, that is present state, you can say, when x is equal to 0. And when present state is 0, 0, and present state is 0, 0, and x is 1, it will jump to the next state will be 0, 1. Clear? Next, 0, 1, if present state is 0, 1, if present state is 0, 1, and x is equal to 0, and x is equal to 0, what happens? It will jump to the next state, which is equal to 0, 0. Next, when present state is 0, 1, and present state is 0, so when present state is 0, 1, when present state is 0, 1, right, and input is 1, and present state is 0, 1, and input is 1, it will change to the next state, which is equal to 1, 0, right? Next, when present state is 1, 0, when present state is 1, 0, and x is 0, it remains in its previous state. It remains in its present state, that is 1, 0, right? Next, when present state is 1, 1, and when present state is 1, 0, and x is equal to 1, it will jump to the next state, which is equal to 0, 0, right? And there is no state called 1, 1. There is no state called 1, 1. So we will put don't. The next state, we don't have any next state for 1, 1, right? So we will put don't care instead of 0, right? So now, I cannot directly fill the columns of DA and DB directly. We need excitation table for it. Excitation table of D flip flop we need, right? So now I can fill out the Z column, the output column I can fill out, right? So when x is equal to 0, just check when x is equal to 0, y is z is equal to 0 for present state, which is equal to 0, 0. And when present state is 0, 0, and x is 1, what is z? Z is again equal to 0, right? Next, when present state is 0, 1, and x is 0, z is 0. When present state is 0, 1 and x is 1, again z is equal to 0. Next, when present state is 1, 0 and x is 0, again z is equal to 0. And present state is 1, 0, next when x is equal to 1, z is equal to 1. Right? And there is no state called 1, 1, so we will put don't care. This is the z value. To fill out the columns of DA and DB, we need the excitation table of D flip flop, right? So that we obtained when we were solving the problems on counters. So when I have present state and next state, right? So the excitation table of D flip flop was obtained, and 0, 0, you just go through the how I obtained that excitation table. 1, 0 and 1, 1, right? So even if you want, I'll explain here quickly, okay? So here, this is the application table of D flip-flop. This we obtained while obtaining the characteristic equation, right? So from this application table itself, the excitation table of D flip-flop can be written. So how to write now? Now Q and Q plus are the inputs, right? And D will be my output, right? So from the application table, we are going to obtain these two values. Q and Q plus equal to 0, 0, D is 0. Q is 0, Q plus is 1, D value is 1, right? 0, 1, D is 1. 1, 0, D is 0. And 1, 1, D is 1, right? This is the same excitation table of D flip flop. Now, by referring this excitation table of D flip flop, we are going to fill out the columns of DA and DB. Now, the present state is A. Instead of Q, I have taken it as A, and next state I have taken it as A plus. Similarly, B and B plus. So, those two columns are seen to fill out the respective columns of DA and DB. For DA, you see the columns A and A plus. When both are 0, output is dA is equal to 0, and both are this is 0 and this is 0, this is 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, and A plus Q plus is 1, D is 1, right? Next, 1, 1, it is 1, next, 1, 0, it is 0. There is no state called 1 don't care, so we will put don't care here, right? Similarly, don't care here. Now, for DB, we have to check the values of B and B plus. B is 0, B plus is 0, so 0. B is 0, B plus is 1, so 1. 1, 0, 0. 1, 0, 0. Then 0, 0, 0. 0, 0, 0. Right? These are the columns of DA and DB. Now we have to put the K-map for DA, DB and output. These are what? The input, flip-flop inputs you can say. DA and DB are the flip-flop inputs. Right? So to obtain the Boolean expression, we need to put a K-map for DA, DB and Z. Right? So with those Boolean expressions, we are going to draw our final circuit. So these are the K-map for DA, and this is for DB, and this is for Z. Okay, so let us group these elements. DA, what is the expression for DA? It is BX plus this don't care can be grouped with this one. So AX bar, BX plus AX bar. What is the expression for DB? This one cannot be grouped with any of the don't care, so it has to be grouped individually. So it is A bar, B bar and X. And finally, what is the expression for Z? This one can be grouped with this don't care, so it is equal to AX, right? So now we will implement these Boolean expressions and using flip-flop. Okay. So now we need two flip-flops. We need two flip-flops, DA for DA and DB, right? The input for first flip-flop is DA and second flip-flop is DB, right? And the input output of first flip-flop is A, output of second flip-flop is B, right? So what is DA now? It is BX plus A X bar. That is X bar, and this is A. And both are logical OR, and output of OR gate is given to D. Next, DB. What is DB? It is A bar. This is A bar. What is DB? DB is equal to A bar. Where is A bar? A bar is here. No need to use one NOT gate. And B bar. B bar is here. You can directly make use of A bar and B bar. And X. All are combined. They are given to AND gate. Output of AND gate is connected to DB. And finally, Z is equal to. Z is A and X. This is the output, that is Z. Okay, and you can connect the synchronous clocks here. Clocks, both clocks are shorted and given into control signal called clock. So in this way we are going to obtain the sequential circuit for the given state diagram. I hope you understood the concept. If you have not, please rewind the video and recheck it. Okay, better you practice the things, right? Better until and unless you practice, you cannot design the circuit properly. Okay, you will make a mistake and you will get the doubts once you start solving the problem. Okay, thank you.